My dear IGCSE or O-level students everywhere, hi again. According to many students requesting about mensuration, we'll be starting today with mensuration. And I will start this from the scratch, from the beginning. So we'll be a bit fast in this. So read. You read the pages of this video, you read the pages written. Just I'll be going fast with this because this like well-known information. But many students like, they need to understand mensuration well. In the IGCSE exam, past papers and the exams in general, the challenging questions come on this chapter. But today we'll be starting from the scratch, from the beginning, from the basics. So what do you mean? Let's start by what does mensuration mean first. Mensuration is a part of mathematics that deals, it's written here in this page, but you read it by yourselves, that deals with measuring areas and lengths and perimeters of the basic 2D shapes and compound 2D shapes. At the same time, with the volume and surface area of the 3D figures. Mainly our work in this chapter and the exams, how to do, find the area and the perimeter of combined or compound shapes, complex shapes, set of combined basic shapes. Because of this, we have to memorize, my dear students, the basic areas in this page. I have to memorize them well. I cannot miss between them, and I have to understand and memorize them well. So most of you, because you took this in the stages before IGCSE grades, year 9, year 10, you took it in year 7, year 8. So according to the country, some countries, they start IGs from year 9, so know this well. Most of countries, they teach this before, but will not consider that you know it. So I wrote it to you. I have to know the rectangle, the area of the rectangle. Each rectangle has length and width. Yes? So I have to memorize that. Area of the rectangle is its length times its width. Area of the square, you know, it's four-sided figure with equal sides. So this is L, this is L, this is L, and so on. So the length and the width of the rectangle, of the square, they are equal. So we don't say width, it's the length of the square. So we say in English, it's a square of length L. So its area is L times itself. Parallelograms. Parallelogram, like you know the parallelogram, it's has base and height. This is its base, this is its height. Since we have property from this is high just to fix handwriting. Yes. Since we know from property of the parallelogram, if we do draw diagonal, it's called the diagonal of parallelogram. The diagonal bisects parallelogram into two triangles. Because of this, this will imply, will give the area of the triangle, since the triangle is half of parallelogram. From here this formula came. So since this diagonal bisects a parallelogram into two triangles, area of the triangle is half times base times height, half of the area of the parallelogram. And remember, the base in both shapes, in parallelograms or triangles, It must make 90 degrees with the base. It must make 90 degrees with the base. Trapezium is four-sided figure that has two parallel sides. That they are called the bases of the trapezium, to remind you fast. Yes? So the parallel sides are the bases of the trapezium. The area of the trapezium is half times the sum of the bases. We add the bases times the height, times the height, distance between the bases. That must make 90 degrees to the bases. Shape number six, the last shape, is the circle. Is the circle. The last basic shape of the shape is the circle. All of us, we know the circle. Circle, this circle of radius r, its area is pi r squared. Pi, the ratio of the circle, pi, between the circumference, r squared. Circumference, or the length of the circle is called circumference. It's given by 2 pi r time, or pi d, where d is the diameter of the circle. D is 2r. If this is r, so this is r also, yes? This is called, this is well known information to you, but this is d, the diameter of the circle. Yes? Now let's discuss quickly how to find the perimeter and the area of some shapes. The perimeter, or the length of 2D shapes, is two cases in our grade in the IGs. First one, if you are given a polygon, you remember a polygon from geometry? A polygon, it's a connected closed shape that its sides non-overlapping and all of them must be connected, straight edges, straight, like these shapes. These are called polygons. Rectangle, square, parallelogram, from 1 to 5, they are polygons. They are polygons. The perimeter of any polygon, whatever it is, because some students here, they learn even some books, they do formulas for each shape, formula of the perimeter for each shape. It's confusing in this way. Easier to the IGCSE student to understand like this. The perimeter of a polygon, the perimeter of a polygon is the sum of the lengths of the sides. You go around the shape. The sum of the lengths of the sides. For example, we know this before, most of us as IG students, that the perimeter of the rectangle is 2L plus 2W. We don't do this, don't. Why I'm saying this? Because this logic in the perimeter that we wrote here works with any shape. It has a name, it's common shape, it's famous, it's not, it works. So just we find the perimeter, we choose a point, then we go around the shape like this, we add the sides. We start from a point, then we'll be back to it, go around the shape. Yes? So in the case of a rectangle, just 8 plus 6 plus 8 plus 6, since each two opposite sides are equal, you find the perimeter 28. For this shape, for example, you cannot write a formula for this shape. No formula of perimeter. So how you find the perimeter? We add the sides. That's it. So for this part, you start from here, for example. 1, go around. 8 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 9 plus 7 again. Then you find the perimeter, which is 42 centimeters. And pay attention to the units, these units. Perimeter is the length, so its unit is a length feel it, yeah? Yes. The length or perimeter of a circle or parts of circle, like we're seeing in the last part after this, it's called the circumference of the circle. Circumference of the circle. That we represented or denoted by C. By C. That equals to 2 pi r. Or pi d. 2 pi r or pi d. For example, this is a circle of radius 3 centimeters. So its circumference, it's 2 pi times 3, 2 pi r, 6 pi centimeters. If he said leave your answer in pi, you stop here, it's okay in the exams. If he wants the answer in decimals or you are free, if he didn't restrict you, he didn't write restriction. So you write your answers to three significant figures, 6 times pi, rounded to three significant figures is 18.9 centimeter. For a semicircle, we use the same rule. So this is a semicircle of diameter 7. Its D is 7. So the circumference of the circle is pi times 7, dividing by 2. Why dividing by 2? Because this is a semicircle, half a circle. Semi means it's half a circle. So we divide the circumference of the circle by 2, gives you the answer. We set our main work in the introduction of the chapter to find the area and perimeter of combined or compound shapes, like the last example here. So I will find the area and perimeter of the following shape, of this shape. Find the area and perimeter. To find the area of the shape, to find the area of the shape. Notice that area is the total area of the shape. Yeah? Notice that this shape is combined from shapes. So how you find the area of such shapes? How to find it? By dividing, by split it. Split the shape. This is the idea. Into basic shapes. Into basic shapes, divided into basic shapes. In this case, this shape is shape number one, rectangle, shape number two, semicircle, shape number three is a triangle. So the area of this shape is equal to area of rectangle plus a semicircle plus a triangle. Simply, we just, because we know now, we have to memorize, we said, the area of each basic shape. So area of the rectangle is length times width. Area of the semicircle, this, when you write R on this rectangle, so this is 10. So this is 10 already, which is the diameter of the circle. So we need R, D, D is 10, so R is 5. D is 10, so the radius is 5 of the circle. So what's the area of the circle? It's pi times the square of the radius, dividing by 2 because this is a semicircle. A semicircle plus the triangle now. Triangle, what's the area of the triangle? It's half times base times height. We know the height is 8. So what is this here? This is 18. Look, this is 18. And you are given this and this are equal. Each one is 6. So this is 6 also. So the base of the triangle is 6. So the area of the triangle is half times base, which is 6. Times height, which is 8. Then by calculator, you add them. This is 180. This is 25 pi, which is 2 over 2, 12.5 pi plus 24. Then you catch the calculator. Of course, to make it easy to you, Yes, most of you good in calculator and good in this topic already, but some students may need it, so I started from the basics. So you start in the calculator 12.55 first. Start with this first. Easier to us. Times pi plus 180 plus 24. 243 centimeters to three significant figures. Why I always write three significant figures? Remember in the IGCSE exams, if you are not given degrees of accuracy, you write your answers to three significant figures. Okay, the perimeter of the shape. The perimeter of the shape. We said we choose a point, and we go around the shape, my dear students, around the shape. Focus here. It's easy topic, but some students, they do fatal mistakes in this and in the next part or the parts after when we do surface area of 3D shape. Some of the questions, they are challenging. It's not hard topic, but because we have problems with the basics. So in the perimeter, we don't go inside the shape. So for I will do it, sketch it to you. For example, I will walk from here. So this 10, I will write it now, but look, this is the perimeter of the shape. This is the perimeter. You see it? Then we'll be back to the point that we started from. We don't go inside the shape. So the perimeter equals to what then? As I did. You can walk from here, you can start from anywhere. It's up to us. It's up to you as a student. So I walked from here. This is the path. Then I'll be back to here again. So the perimeter is equal to 10 plus 6, which is this, plus 8, which is this, plus this now. This is not given. But we know from trigonometry and right angle triangles, lessons before, or you know from your schools, this is a right angle triangle. This we can find it by Pythagoras. Add this is 100. So this is 10. By squaring root 100, this is 10. So this is 10 now. So plus 10, plus 6. Plus this part, which is the length or circumference of the semicircle, which is pi times d, which is the circumference of the circle, dividing by 2, because this is a semicircle, plus 18. So again, 1, here 10, plus 1, 10, plus 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Check like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Check that, you covered all the parts. Then you catch your calculator and we just add them, simply like this. 10 plus 6 is 16, plus 8 is 24, plus 10 is 34, plus 6 is 40, plus 18 is 58. So this is 58 plus 5 pi. If he said write your answers in pi, leave it like this. We finished. If he doesn't, if he wants to answer in decimals, so you do your answer in decimal, you will get 73.7 centimeter whole square, of course. This is the area. Yes? And this centimeter because it's a perimeter. Some students may wonder, they say, observe, you say the circumference here, yeah. Why we can say in English here the perimeter of, because we have straight edges other than the circle. So in general, we say the perimeter of the shape. For the circle, we say circumference. This is easy part for the students, they feel they need this, it's good. Because we'll move forward now to the harder cases in 3D shapes, and then you'll do past paper problems in the past when you do solve past paper, full past paper exams. You'll be good and fine in this in this chapter or this topic. We hope. Okay, wait for us for the next to move on with the volume and surface area. Thank you.